स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द न्यू लेसन ऑफ IELTS राइटिंग टास्क। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टास्क 1 एंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू स्पेशली डिस्कस ग्राफ इंटरप्रिटेशन। माई नेम इज डॉक्टर सागर पंड्या एंड आई एम श्योर आफ्टर लिसनिंग टू दिस लेसन योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग रिगार्डिंग ग्राफ इंटरप्रिटेशन विल इंक्रीज। लेट मी एक्सप्लेन यू that graph interpretation is not a very easy task, and in IELTS the graph that you are going to get may be of different type as well. In this particular lesson we are going to discuss about single bar graph and double bar graph. I will specifically discuss how you can introduce the topic, how you can compare, and how you can show contrast. We will start the discussion by discussing about single bar graph, and the first slide over here is about introduction. I am sure that in this particular slide you are able to see a bar graph where you can see that there are yellow colored pillars kept over here. I am sure you can observe that the USA shows the highest pillar and the lowest pillar is of Japan. When you are discussing about introduction, let me tell you that you are supposed to do paraphrasing of the topic. Here, by observing the graph, you can easily understand that the graph is about annual meat consumption in 7 countries that are listed below, and the amount is given in kg per person, kilogram per person. Let me show how the introduction is written. You can see on the left hand side the introduction. It is the vertical bar graph provides the information of yearly consumption of meat in 7 nations worldwide. The data provides details in number of meat consumed in kilogram per person. I'm sure if you will analyze this particular write-up, then you will understand that here we have tried to use some synonyms and we are trying to explain the topic in our own words. In the bracket it is provided that you may mention the name of countries as well. It depends on you how you want to present this particular bar graph, but I am sure if you will start listing the countries then the number goes quite high, so it is preferable that we don't use that. Now let's see how to do comparison of the same graph. You are already aware about the graph, so I'm not going to discuss about that, but I just would like to tell you that if you will see the kilogram mentioned over here, it starts from 0 and it goes to as high as 140 kilogram, and there are 7 countries also provided below. The content provided over here is China and Russia stand at the same position in meat consumption, which is 40 kg per person annually, just 1% higher than Japan. I am sure if you will start analyzing the graph and if you understand, it is quite clear that China and Russia, their number is at the similar position. And if you will minutely see, Japan is a little lower, just one number less than that. So this is how I have tried to put this information in a format. I hope when you will read the sentence, you will understand how exactly it is done. You can reread the statement so that you will get better clarity on that. Now we will try to understand how to show contrast. You can see the statement provided over here. It goes like this. The USA tops the list with 120 kg meat consumption yearly, which is 80 kg more than Japan, standing at the lowest with 40 kg. I'm sure you all know that when you are analyzing the graph, you have to show the contrast of the highest and the lowest. And in this statement, we are trying to do the same. I hope single bar graph explanation is understood by you. And I'm sure when you will start writing, you will do a better job. Now, let me take you to double bar graph. We will again start with the introduction. And as I told you, you are supposed to provide a paraphrase of that. Here in the graph, you are clearly able to see that there are blue colored bars and red color bars. The blue color stands for British home students and the red color stands for international students. The entire graph is divided in two parts where they are discussing about, they are displaying about males and females who are studying. Let me take you to introduction. It goes like this. The vertical bar graph illustrates the number of local and global learners studying in Britain from the year of 2010 to 2012. The graph is bifurcated in displaying the details of male and female students. I'm sure if you will work a little more on understanding the synonyms and how to rewrite the same topic in your own words, then definitely paraphrasing will not be very difficult for you. The next slide talks about the comparison. As you are aware about the content of the graph, let me straight away take you to the sentence, which goes like this. In 2011, the number of local male students learning was 24, which is only one student more than the number of international students. I want you to pay attention to the first part of the graph, which talks about male students. You can see over here 2010, 2011 and 2012 years written, where they are only talking about male students who were taking admission. You can see here that in 2011, the blue color bar is a little higher than the red color. The blue color bar stands for British home students and the red color bar stands for international students. And if you will keep this in mind and read the statement one more time, it will make definitely a little more sense and it will also teach you how you can make proper sentences. Now, let me take you and show you how contrast can be presented. The sentence goes like this. After 32 students in 2010, the number of British female learners has only seen an upward trend, 44 in 2011 and 45 in 2012. If you will pay attention again, you will realize and understand that we are only talking about British female learners who are studying. And if you will see in the chart, it is very clear that in 2010, the number was a little more than 30, that is 32. And in 2011 and 12, you can see that the number is only going higher year by year. I'm sure this particular explanation was helpful to you. And next time when you are describing the graph, this particular explanation will enable you to understand the graph better. We have discussed single bar graph and double bar graph. And I'm sure with this understanding, you will be able to write in a much better way.